Welcome to CertBlaster. In this session, we'll look at the multiple-choice single-answer question type and the strategies you can use to increase your chances of success by weeding out the bad responses. Start by carefully examining them to weed out the unnecessary and distracting content to make the correct response a little easier to identify. Here's your first question. Which would represent the most basic SOHO WAP configuration? It's not the recommended configuration, but it's usually how a consumer would receive their router to set it up out of the box. As you look at your options, essentially what you're looking for is the easiest way into the router. WAP was once all you'd ever need in terms of security. It delivers wired equivalent privacy. Today's computational horsepower can crack a WAP passphrase in minutes, as opposed to hours or days it once took. But it's still better than nothing. WPS-PSK wireless protected setup with a pre-shared key is adequate in a SOHO environment, but remember, we're looking for the easiest way in. WPA-PSK wireless protected access with a pre-shared key is the most secure of all and therefore the least likely choice. And there you have it, one choice left standing. Open, as the name implies, is. The SSID will be broadcast and the password is a simple, widely known password like admin. The router manufacturer's initial concern is that the user be able to connect to and perform the initial router configuration. The initial router configuration is done using a direct Ethernet connection between the computer and the router. All the questions should be that simple, but they're not. Many are close if you deductively reason away the junk. Here's your next question. A user in the graphics art department is reporting network dropouts. They have an intermittent all-or-nothing connection. You find this unusual because the company just upgraded from 10BASE-T to fiber to the desktop for the graphics art department. The rest of the workstations in the area are working optimally. You test the connection on the workstation, cable, wall jack, and they're all good. Tracing the connection back to the wiring closet, you find 15 feet of excess cable tightly coiled and labeled with the workstation's jack number hanging on the wall behind the rack. What do you think the problem is? There should be no excess cable. Well, there should be some slack, but not 15 feet. None of these is a problem. You should keep looking. The cable exceeds the maximum length. The cable length issue can be ruled out because the fiber optic cable replaced 10BASE-T cable that operates over shorter distances. The cable's wrapped too tightly, exceeding the bend radius. This is correct. The fiber optic cable is the backbone of today's most advanced communication networks. For all the advancements, it does have one obstacle it can't overcome, and that's signal path. The light must have an unobstructed signal path. What this means to an installer or technician is that typically the cable will lose light or become impaired if the cable's kinked or bent past a minimum radius determined by the thickness. Typically, this is 15 times the cable diameter. In this particular case, the tightly coiled cable is the most obvious problem. Here's one more. You're the new network technician hired recently by a mid-sized insurance company. During discussions with your network admin about your job responsibilities, the subject of installing updates and patches on system servers and workstations arises. Your discussion goes on to cover different types of updates, service packs, and hot fixes. Which of the following updates do you agree can be installed automatically without your consent or evaluation? All the items listed are essential to keep your system up to date and safe. However, a service pack should be tested on non-mission critical hardware to make sure no abnormalities are introduced. They're applied case by case. The same level of care should be applied to hot fixes and security patches. The exception to this precaution would be your antivirus or anti-malware software. These are independent programs that require frequent updating and are not capable of causing system problems when their signatures are updated. Hopefully this video helps you apply deductive reasoning to challenging questions. Remember, knowing what something isn't is often as valuable as knowing what it is. You can also check out CertBlaster.com for more learning resources and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this. Good luck!